tutorial responds back, "Miss Tutor, I'm just going to show you how you can quickly change the colour of a rectangle and a circle." So I'm just going to apply them as a shape. So just going to select the colour there. Just before you start, you've got to change the colour there. Likewise for the circle. Now it will use that colour there. So just going to add a circle, and also going to add a rectangle. Now, once you've actually got those, just go over here and you've got properties. Now, while you've actually got this selected, also when you just go up here as well, you've got the move tool, you'll notice that there's a properties option here, window and properties, just there. And you'll see the colour there. So you can change the colour of that rectangle just by just changing it there. So maybe you want it red, just go over there and you can change the shape to blue. Now, that's a quick way of changing the colour of circle and rectangle. But say you've got, now I'm just going to quickly go over, you've selected, say, that tool or any of these other tools. Again, it's still available to be able to change there. So you just quickly change that like that. But when you actually go over here to the actual circle or ellipse tool, I should say, and rectangle, what you can do is you can just change it up here as well. So there's an option here as well. Can't normally see that unless you've actually selected the ellipse or rectangle. So you can change the colour very quick and simple there. Now, you can also change the colour of this just by quickly going to the layer and go to a layer style and colour overlay. It's another option. And you can see you can just add colour on top there, as well as gradient, etc. Once it wants to appear. So you just get that. Okay, so you've just got that gradient there. Click OK. Now, of course, if you flatten the design, not so much easier, not much better. But what you can do then, obviously, you can change the colour just by going to adjustments. But then, of course, it modifies the whole of that. Now, another option, and I'm just going to undo that again. So I've just got that, say, that shape there. What you can do, you can go and you think, nope, no availability of the adjustments. Well, what you can do, just go to a layer and smart object, convert to smart object. So once you've done that, then you can go to image and adjustments, and then you can modify again. That's, let's say you want to invert or maybe other hue and saturation. And again, just want to tweak that, click OK. Now, if you actually want to change the properties of those, you can just see over, go over there, hue and saturation, double click on there to bring up the various settings. You can just quickly modify it again. There is just a quick run through of some of the ways of changing colour of a shape like rectangle and also the ellipse. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you very much.